Hi, good morning. So today I'm going to try and show our guests how to actually ignite the rocket stove. It's called a silver fire. I'm just going to stop for a moment. This is the silver fire rocket stove. You can see on the top we have a cast iron base where you can put different pans. Down here you have the fuel tray. This just clips in and out. And basically, this stove is very efficient in how it burns. You need a very small amount of fuel. You can use things such as, you know, cardboard, organic material, cones, corn cobs, hay, straw, anything of that nature really. Paper and card, actual kindling. Preferably, they say matchstick size. I mean, these are rather large, so I'm not sure how this is going to go. This is the very first time for everything. I think my cones might be a bit wet, so we could end up bit smoky. It's supposed to be, you know, dry fuel if you want it as smokeless as possible, and it should burn fairly smokeless. So basically you feed your fuel into here, get your fire going. It heats up very rapidly, that's why it's called a rocket stove. The heat will come up through the middle here. This skin should stay fairly cool, and it's got handles. The body is stainless steel. So I'm just going to pause this for a moment while I light my fire. So I don't know if you can see that, I've fed some cardboard and stuff in there, and I'm just about to light some. Well, after probably about at least half a dozen matches, finally got a little bit of smoke coming up through there, and the fire's getting going. And yeah, you can see that in there. So let's pop that hatch down. Get that out a minute, I think. And I'm gonna pop the kettle up. And yes, you can see down the chimney there. Let's see, this is all trial and error. This is the first time I've ever used the rocket stove. And it says you should be able to boil a full kettle within about 5 to 7 minutes. Quite efficient, produces a lot of heat. So you can just about see through the little window that you've got, you know, your fire's okay in there. I might need to pop some more kindling in or a little bit more paper to keep it going. But yeah, now it's just a matter of sitting back and waiting for the kettle to come to the boil for a nice cup of tea. Okay, so finally got that going. That did take a bit of getting going actually. I've now used about half a box of matches. Definitely the key to this is having some actual little organic fire lighters, I think, because once that got going, and then my kindling caught, and we're going now, and we've got flame at the top and the pan's starting to heat up. So finally we've got going, and that's all a learning curve. So I've also prepared some instructions which I've laminated for how to start the rocket stove, and also on the reverse is just a few troubleshooting tips if you get too much smoke or difficult to light or whatever. Just a few safety tips there as well. And I'm hoping to actually put together some different recipe ideas as well, and maybe trial the dragon pot that comes with it. And also this particular model we've bought to accompany it a griddle, which has got a double side, so you can put on the ridged side you can do your steaks and sausages and burgers and things like that, and I think the other side is dead flat, and maybe that's for like a pizza stove or something. So lots of attachments and things that come with this, and accessories. So just to show you, in addition to the rocket stove information, this here's this skillet I was telling you about for cooking on top. You place that on the hot plate on top, and that's the reverse side. You see, you have a flat side, possibly good for pizza and things, and you have the ridge side. So this is the dragon pot that goes with the silver fire rocket stove. It's stainless steel, it's very large, so it's quite big capacity if you wanted to do like a stew or pasta or rice dish, something like that. Basically, it sits on top of the dragon stove, and then the flames will, it's like double skinned, so the flames lick up inside here, so you get quite rapid heating. So these are just the additional things that come alongside the rocket stove. So I think it makes it a very versatile and useful thing. So finally, I've got my kettle boiled. Took a long time actually. My whistling kettle didn't whistle, so that was a bit disappointing. So I was having to really listen to see if it had indeed boiled. I had to use quite a bit more fuel than I thought, but I think my mistake was I used just enough fuel to sort of get a nice simmer going. So what I should have done, you know, more fuel, more fire, and I should have stoked that up and got quite a raging fire going initially to get that to come up to the boil. So that's taken a long time, certainly not 7 minutes, more like half an hour. But it's been very enjoyable. Really enjoyable actually, just sitting here in the sun and stoking my fire. Let me just get that bag out there. And so, yeah, first cup of tea made with the rocket stove. And to be fair, I don't normally light our log burners. My husband's usually the one to do that because I'm not very good at it. So the fact that I, the fact that I managed to get that going relatively easily, almost, you know, with just a few matches, and as soon as I use the fire lighter, the cardboard fire lighters, the organic one's absolutely fine, you know, lit straight away. So it was great feeding the fire. The only, as I say, I think the only thing I did wrong was I just didn't use enough fuel in the beginning to really get the fire going, to get that kettle to come up to the boil. But what the temperature I had going was just a gentle burn, and I think would be amazing and perfect for sort of simmering a stew, or if you were frying something, you didn't want the flame too high. So it's just, it's all a learning curve. So initially, very impressed. Easy, fairly easy to use, even for me. And if I can do it, I think most people can.